where donkeys drive by boat through turquoise water and a labyrinth of bays. Even the gods of ancient times enjoyed life in the Turkish part of the Aegean. The Turkish Aegean. It may seem unimpressive, but it's quite special. Esek Adasi. Donkey Island. It's a refuge for old, sick, and neglected donkeys. Here, they're made healthy again. Right across the sea on the mainland lies Çeşme, a town with a history as a fortress and famous with the locals as a seaside resort. Gürol Algan is a fisherman, but he rescues donkeys in his spare time.
Someone told me that there was a sick donkey around here somewhere, in very poor health. Maybe over there.
The animal stands beside a field.
Stay still. He's badly groomed and slimmed down. The hooves are quite long.
That's an indication that the donkey wasn't allowed to run free for months at a time.
It looks as if the owners haven't cared for him for quite some time. These wounds are rather old and still infected. It's a miracle that he's still able to move like that.
The owner is a farmer from Çeşme.
Hello, how are you? My name is Murat.
I'm Gürol. Is that your donkey? I'd like to buy him.
His name is Mesut. Let me pamper him up a bit before you take him.
No, I'd like to take him now. How much do you want for him?
Just give me 100 lira.
I can't do 100.
Why not? Come on.
For an animal like that? No, I'll give you 50.
No way. I won't sell for less than 100. It's a good donkey.
No.
Come on, let's shake on it. Give me how much you think he's worth.
The donkey savior pays 80 lira, about 28 euros for the gaunt animal. Now, Gürol will take the donkey home to look after his wounds and feed him properly. Later, he'll be taken to Donkey Island. Around Çeşme, Gürol has already rescued more than 50 donkeys. He finances the purchase and transport of the animals by donations.
In former times, the donkeys were needed for field work. But now, people can afford tractors, so they just abandon them. And as the animals are used to getting fed, they don't eat well. And that's why Mesut is slimmed down so much.
Dışarıda afallayıp kalıyor, bu sefer bu zayıflama olayları bu hale geliyor.
Look, Mesut, over there is the Donkey Island. This will be your new home, with 50 other donkeys and females, many females.
The famous Greek historian Herodotus wrote that the Turkish part of the Aegean had the best climate and the most beautiful sky in the world. The whole western coast of Turkey borders on the Aegean. The Greek islands are in sight. It's 4 o'clock in the morning at Akyaka Harbor. Mehmet Dogan sails out to fish. His boss is still allowed a few hours of sleep below deck.
My wife is the boss. I'll drive out the boat and she'll do the fishing. Let's see if we're lucky today.
So Mehmet prepares things while his wife is still asleep. As a deckhand. His duties include laying the long line. And cooking the tea, without waking the boss. Tea in Turkey is a cultural asset. Everything depends on the right preparation. He needs 2 pots for it.
First, you add the loose tea on top. Once the water boils below, you start pouring over the warm tea, adding more water over time. Then it needs to steep.
Only when everything is perfect is he allowed to wake his wife.
Gulay, wake up.
Good morning.
Gule and Mehmet have been married for 20 years.
Usually the women here are housewives, so they're the boss at home. I'm both the boss at home and here at sea as well. 2 in 1.
After Mehmet has everything ready, his wife takes over command.
Over there, a bit more in that direction. Of course, we work together, but I make the decisions. I'm the director. The thing is, I'm better than most fishermen. It's the same here on deck. My man is a good man, but I'm faster, more hardworking and tidy. And practical. I wouldn't trade myself against a man here.
the Turkish Aegean is dependent on tourism. But still, there are many secluded bays, pristine beaches, and lots of culture. Where the Aegean meets the Mediterranean lies the town of Dalyan. It's famous for its rock-cut tombs from the 4th to 6th century BC. Under the Lycians' rule, it wasn't kings who were buried here, but regular people. But historical Dalyan is also home of the only turtle hospital in Turkey. The doctors are busy here. They admit about 30 patients per year. Careta careta, the loggerhead sea turtle. Most common injuries stem from collisions with one of the many pleasure and fishing boats. This turtle has been treated here for a week now.
Careful, hold her still. She got hit on the head by a fishing boat and lost her memory.
The turtle suffers from a head trauma and has forgotten how to eat.
Now the fish.
The animal needs to be fed like that once a day.
We do the routine every day at the same time. Feeding, mouth care, medication.
Iodine tincture is supposed to kill bacteria and protect the weak turtle from infections.
We do that with every animal, and we change their water every day.
In a year, it'll be set free again. Istuzu Beach is the breeding ground of Careta Careta. It's a nature reserve now. And the credit for that belongs to 91-year-old June Haimoff. She spends every day working with the turtles. Every morning, she collects the washed-up waste.
It's very bad. If they swallow that and it gets into their stomach, they can die. Or stuck in the throat. That's very bad.
31 years ago, the Englishwoman spent her vacation here and stayed.
I saw one in the night, and it was a very moving experience. To see this large creature, looked like a rock at first, but it was a turtle, and to lie quietly there nearby and watch her make her nest was a most moving experience. The determination, you see, the devotion of a mother on a beach at night, got to lay the eggs. And then, very tired, she just made like a sigh. Like that, and very tired, she went back into the sea, and I watched her go under the waves. Well, it changed my life.
Today, she's on her way again. She's headed for the harbor, the shipyard. As she lives on the outskirts of town, she has to rely on her car. Her beetle accompanies her since she settled in Turkey. But she doesn't drive that fast anymore.
To be honest, I'm not as fast as I used to be. And my sight is still, we can say, good enough for easy driving.
Easy driving and easy living at 91.
I don't think about my age. I just think I'm June, and I'm here, and I've got a car, and I look at it a bit like that, you know. I don't usually look at myself as somebody very, very old who shouldn't be doing this or shouldn't be doing that.
A new ship's propeller protection is supposed to be attached today at the shipyard. It's financed by June via donations and the inheritance from her husband.
Yes, well, this will protect the turtle from this side if it comes here. Otherwise, if it hits there, it will lose its nose or its flipper.
Every boat owner gets this protection from June for free.
There are roughly 600 boats on the river. We'd like to see that everyone had one.
But so far, they've only converted 40 boats. Many more to go for June. In ancient times, the Turkish Aegean was an important cultural and economic region. The biggest and most significant cities of Greece and the Roman Empire were located here: Troy, Ephesus, Pergamon. In Assos, you can still see the ruins of the Temple of Athena. The great ancient philosopher Aristotle lived here. And there's another thing Assos is famous for. Claims Ahmet Kaplan, meaning his ice cream. Famous for its rubbery consistency. The chewier, the better.
My ice cream is unique. You can see the quality. Bad ice cream wouldn't stretch like that. If you find it anywhere else, they copied it from me. The most important ingredient is salep, ground orchid root.
Salep was considered an aphrodisiac in the Ottoman Empire.
Come here, I've got the famous ice cream.
I especially love the one with almonds and honey, but they're all good.
Even people from Istanbul come here to taste his ice cream, says Ahmet. He serves his customers 7 days a week from 9 in the morning until late at night. Everyone will get his or her treat. Rubbery ice cream from Assos almost around the clock.
I don't mind the long hours. On the contrary, I've got nature and the sea around me. I feel like working together with Aristotle. That gives me strength. We're both from Assos. That's what connects us. I'm very happy here.
In Çeşme Harbor, before Mesut embarks on his journey to Donkey Island, he gets a special treatment from donkey rescuer Gürol. He's got a real miracle drug.
That's shampoo for men, with menthol. Very refreshing when it's hot. It stimulates and livens up his body. It's great. I use it as well.
Half a bottle of menthol shampoo prepares the donkey for the island. After all, there are also 20 jennies there.
Oh,
Who knows how often he's been washed like this?
Now, Masut needs to dry off so that he doesn't catch a cold during the passage.
You're a lion, a real man. You smell so good.
The Bosporan Peninsula at the most southern tip of the Aegean coast. The gulets, famous wooden sailing boats, are built here. Even billionaire Bill Gates owns one. And it's rumored that several Hollywood actors ordered wooden boats from small Bosporan. He takes part in each and every construction. Master Mehmet.
I'm an electrician, and I've been doing this for 35 years now. I haven't slipped up even once during that time.
Without Mehmet Yaşar, the boats wouldn't have warm water, lights, or luxury. Today, his nephew asks for his advice. He's working on a 22-meter gulet. There are five family-owned boatyards in Bosporan.
Good morning. How's it going?
I'm good, Uncle, thanks.
What is it that you need to know?
The deck is supposed to be illuminated spectacularly in many colors. Therefore, Mehmet needs to run 5 kilometers of cables down in the boat's hold.
Doing that might take me a year. A beginner will need at least 5. And it will look like that after all. I learned this craft from my father. Growing up as a child here, you're automatically involved in building boats.
Not far away is the boatyard of the Koskun family. They build the most gulets and are Master Mehmet's biggest clients. Mustafa Koskun is the boss here.
Arkadaşlar afiyet olsun.
Sağ ol, sağ ol.
Afiyet olsun, tek ol.
Sağ ol.
Nereden kaldın?
4 lamps need to go there.
4 tane olsun yani. Tamam.
Bu yılların He's the electrician. He fitted more than 100 boats for us, and we haven't had a single problem so far.
For a long time, the Koskun family's boatyard was the biggest around here. If you wanted the most magnificent boat, you ordered it from them. But that's changed now. Fierce competition has risen next door. They only build a single wooden boat in a gigantic scale. It's rumored to be for Russian billionaire Roman Abramovich.
It's supposed to be the biggest wooden ship in the world, 160 meters long. But we aren't allowed there. They're very cold and secretive people.
Yani yapılıyor yani içinde.
In Dalyan, turtle rescuer June needs to do a lot of persuading. This requires addressing people tactfully and on a personal level.
Merhaba.
Merhaba.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
We'd like to protect the turtles. Where is your boat?
Over there.
It's called PR, in a way, isn't it? It's public relations. But in my case, it's done with heart, with feeling.
A fisherman just moved his boat out of the water.
Where is your propeller protection? You get it from me for free, to protect the turtles.
I'd like to remove the old propeller first. And the new one will get your protection. We'll make it safe for the turtles.
A blast, a message is getting across. And when a few do it, others will follow.
Nobody cared for sea turtles when June Haimoff arrived in Turkey 31 years ago. There were plans for building a hotel at the beach, which would have destroyed the breeding grounds. With great effort, June managed to stop the development.
It was a miracle that a foreign woman, a lonely woman, a woman on her own, could go to the head of government in a country and say, don't spend money on developing that beach. Keep it safe for the turtles and keep it beautiful for future generations. It was very, what's the word, naive and cheeky on my part to do such a thing, but it worked.
Mesut will embark on a little cruise soon, over to Esek Adasi, the Donkey Island. For this special occasion, Gural transforms his fishing boat into a donkey ark.
When the weather conditions are good, I just need to attach him here. If they're bad, I make the donkeys lie down and pet them during the passage so that they stay calm.
The crossing takes an hour. Gural treats the wounds one last time. For the past 13 years, he's spent almost all of his spare time rescuing donkeys.
I love animals in general, but I'm especially fond of donkeys because they've been treated badly for many years. Therefore, they're my priority.
There are no humans living on Donkey Island, but the animals are provided with fresh food and water once a week, supported by donations. Great conditions for Mesut to recover soon.
There are 20 females here, and I'm sure he'll find one for himself. In fact, I think he'll get them all.
What a guy. Yes, you smell great of menthol. It's because he's new on the island and he's a male. The other male donkeys over there smell the competition. But now he's seen the Jennies and they saw him. He wants to get there, but he needs to keep us cool. He's a really strong guy. I can't just let him lose.
How long hasn't he seen?
Lazım, başı başı.
The new guy needs to adjust himself during the first night. Tomorrow morning, the vet will pay the island a visit. After that, Mesut is allowed to join the others.
Gel.
Take care of yourself and you'll be fine. Just be nice and don't get into a fight, okay?
Her şey daha güzel olacak. Arkadaşlarınla iyi geçin. Tamam mı? Kendine iyi bak. Hadi erkek. Bye bye.
There are more than 100 islands in the Turkish Aegean, but only two are inhabited. One of them is Bozcaada. Until 1922, it belonged to Greece and was called Tenedos. It was ceded to Turkey after the peace negotiations of the Grecian-Turkish War. A mixture of Greek and Turkish culture can be found on Bozcaada still today. In Greek legend, Odysseus invigorated himself here with a very special remedy. Wine from the Kuntra grapes. Mehmet Talay is a vintner and still grows this ancient type of grape.
See to it that you pick them correctly. You can see them well now that the leaves are almost gone. We harvest the Kuntra grapes now. It's been a bad year, but it's still worth it.
Kuntra grapes grow exclusively in this region, and there's so few of them that the wine is only sold in Turkey. It's said that it gave special powers to seafarers.
I told you not to harvest those. The warriors from Sparta hid here during the siege of Troy and built the Trojan horse, powered up by Kuntra wine.
The vineyard is a family business. The Talays started it in 1948, but it required Grandpa's blessing.
He was a very religious man. He said, of course you can make wine, but you must guarantee fair prices and salaries for your workers. If you don't, I won't forgive you.
Wine production isn't big business in Turkey. The Turks prefer rakı, their traditional aniseed brandy. But Kuntra is very popular on Bozcaada. 12 families of Greek origin still live here. They call themselves Rum and meet at the Greek Orthodox chapel.
What do we have here today?
Of course, they drink the wine from the Vintner Island. Here, Turks and Greeks regularly have a meal together.
We have a lot in common. We like the same food. We like to celebrate. Our weddings are very similar. It all fits very well on this island.
Hidden behind the hills is a place hardly anyone gets to see, Aya. One of the biggest shipwrecking yards in the world. Six 600 workers from 20 wrecking companies dismantle retired ships here. Neçatin Yoltsu is the manager of Egi Gemisökum, the Aegean scrap trade. Once a day, he makes his rounds.
My foremen report to me, but I also personally supervise what we could offer for sale.
Neçatin buys old ships from all over the world. Each part is recycled. Sometimes, even whole lifeboats.
We check whether it's still functional. And if it is, we prepare it for sale. Ship owners look for something like that. I'm sure we can sell it for a good price.
It takes a month to dismantle a mid-size freighter. There are very few shipwrecking yards of this size in the world. Those in Pakistan, Bangladesh, India, and China are quite infamous due to their bad working conditions. For a long time, health, safety, and environmental issues had been neglected in Aya as well. But for some years now, the scrap traders here are eager to follow EU guidelines. Asbestos, waste oil, and other problematic substances shall be properly disposed of. When Neçatin started working here, there was only one tiny hut.
If you compare it to what it was 21 years ago and now, there's been a lot of change. And if we manage to meet environmental standards, our scrapyard will have a bright future.
In any case, the lifeboat has found a new owner. In Akyaka, Güle and Mehmet caught almost 15 kilos of fish.
That's a big one.
I'm very happy that my wife has such a talent. We're both happy. And we're doing well.
It's their last line. Mehmet, my Mehmet, It's a traditional Turkish love song, and Gule sings it for her husband. Their catch is worth about 70 lira, 24 euros. That's enough for them. After the haul, Mehmet is in charge of the entertainment on board. And for that purpose, he installed a stereo with speakers on deck.
He used to be the owner of the local discotheque. He made people dance.
I was the boss. I even employed a barkeeper.
Party all the time.
Always a big crowd.
He enjoyed that. Sometimes he says that he misses his time at the discotheque. Then he turns up the stereo on deck and we dance a little.
They've been at sea for 8 hours, since 4 o'clock in the morning. But at least they can finish early. Right on time for lunch. They share parts of their catch with friends from the village.
That's Turkish hospitality. We're a real community here.
Even though we're not related, he considers me his sister, and I call him brother.
That's life in the Turkish Aegean. No wonder even the gods in ancient times enjoyed it here. Thank you.